Hi, everybody. It's Tuesday. Welcome to Family Support Q&A at the St. Louis ARC. And we have one of my favorite ARC employees with us today, Lisa Miller. She's going to tell us all about our annual efforts to help out some of our families that may need a little bit of extra support to get the holiday that they deserve. And now, without further ado, I'm going to introduce Lisa Miller and ask Lisa to tell us a little bit about her role at the ARC, but also, Lisa, about your journey at the ARC. When did you start? What all have you done here? Why are you still here? I don't know. All those things.
Well, thank you, Sharon, for having me today. As Sharon said, I'm Lisa Miller. I have been employed here at the St. Louis ARC for 25 years. I started off as a summer position in 1995 in our leisure department. At the time, they had summer camp, and I was one of the camp counselors. I did that for a couple of years. I was one of the program leaders for a while, and then I started working in the leisure department. I was in the leisure department a couple of years, and then I transferred over to our HR department, and I became the HR manager. So I did that for a little over 12 years. With doing that, I took care of, at the beginning, all the new employees coming in. I made sure we had all their paperwork and everything. And from there, then I was taking care of the benefits for the employees before transitioning to where I am now, which is the executive assistant. So that's how I started here. That's how I'm still here. I love the ARC. I was introduced to what I'm going to be speaking about, the Giving Tree, the first year that I started working in the office. And at that point, it was just a little bitty, probably 2-foot tree that had about 10 names on it. The names all were children that were in our PLT program, which stands for Parents Learning Together. All of the parents have some form of a developmental or intellectual disability, and they have had children, and they are trying to raise those children on their own. So we have some amazing coordinators that help with that and help them with learning those skills to be a parent. So those kids, those families struggle lots of times just for, you know, keeping the lights on, the water on, let alone having a Christmas. So when I started off, like there was probably 10 or 12 names on the tree. And I just kind of got started in it from there. And I've been in charge of it, I think around 20 years, somewhere around in there. And from those roughly 10 names to this year, we have 171 kids on the Giving Tree this year. And that does also bring in our CKF program, which is our Capable Kids and Families. With that, there are children that have some type of developmental disability. A lot of times there's a physical disability with that as well. So sometimes the things that you see on the things that they need might be confusing to people that doesn't really seem age appropriate for somebody that's that age, but it is appropriate for that individual at that time.
Thank you. That was a great overview about the Giving Tree. And, you know, I can remember back into those days where we just drew a name off a tree and we were able to purchase, you know, a couple things for a child, and it was fun, but there was no production value. But now, Lisa Miller, it is a production that I think people would be shocked if they could see all that goes into getting all those gifts, because not only do you have to figure out what it is people want, get all the right sizes, then find people who want to get those gifts. You also coordinate all the wrapping of all those gifts, right?
Correct. We have some wonderful volunteers that have been helping us wrap for, I believe we're on our eighth year now, and that is a group from US Bank. It's the same group, it's the same department that comes every year. Somewhere between 13 and 18 of them come, they spend the day with us, and they wrap all the presents, they label all the presents, and they help me make sure everybody's sorted and all the family units are put together as one big family so that we don't miss anything. And they know how to do it. They are a well-oiled machine.
Let's go ahead and start off with just how do you decide what names end up on the giving tree?
We do leave that up to the coordinators for the two programs, the PLT and the CKF. Those coordinators know the folks in their program the best. With that, it's individuals that just financially cannot make ends meet. And without our help, these kids will not have a Christmas. So the coordinators are the ones that talk with the families. They help gather all the information about clothing size, shoe size if they need them, coats, and what an idea might be for some type of toy they might like or what their interest is. You know, maybe a little girl likes unicorns, and so we know that they like unicorns, so anything along that would work. There are some times that the kids really need certain items that some of us kind of take for granted. I know this year there are kids on the list that are asking for blankets, just your average pair of socks and underwear. And it's hard to think that there's kids that actually really need those that don't have them. So my main goal is to make sure the kids get the things that they really need. Lots of times it's coats and shoes at this time of year. They might have started the school year off with a pair of shoes that they had from last year, and our feet just aren't fitting in those shoes anymore. So we try to get those for everybody. And then as well as some type of toy type gift for them as well. And it's kind of the same thing with our capable kids and families coordinators. They know the financial situations of those families, and they work with those families to identify the items that are really needed for them at that time. And they get theirs from that information as well.
So if we have families that want to be a part of the giving tree, what can they do? How do you get started?
This year, I'm excited to say we have everything out online this year. So you can go on to, it's on our website, and then it's also going to be on our social media, as well as I can be contacted and I can send the link as well. Go there, it's through Sign Up Genius, and log into that, and you will see all of the kids listed. And it will say, it'll give you their name, their age, their gender, sizes of clothing that they wear, size of shoes. If they need a coach, that'll be on there. And then it'll list their wish list items, which can be like the toys and things like that. So you'll be able to see all of that, of all the children that are on there. Look through them, and then all you have to do is click on the little button and sign up. It'll ask you for your contact information, just so that I have it, so that if I'm missing somebody's gift at the, when it comes time to have them all back in, that I can get in touch with you to make sure that you're bringing it in, or did you accidentally forget it, or just what that situation is. Because it happens sometimes, and if I don't have the information to find out who it is, then, and it may be just somebody like that's just running behind and like, I'll have it there, you know, before you close today, that's perfectly fine. So it's just enables in order for me to get it, be able to get a hold of you, the basic information. It is not something that we share with anybody, but it's just the information that I need to make the tree work.
All right, well, let's just get down to brass tacks. I don't like to shop. I don't really feel like getting what everybody else wants, but I'd like to contribute. Can I just give you a donation?
Absolutely. I do love to shop, especially for little kids. So it does not bother me at all to go buy gifts for the little kids. So there is a link as well where you can make a monetary donation. And that money is used to buy the gifts for the kids that don't get selected off the tree, or maybe somebody was selected off the tree, but they really needed a coat still. They didn't get a coat. And so it would allow me to have the funds in order to go out and purchase a coat for them to fill that. For me personally, for the kids to have shoes and coats are really important going into the winter. And I feel like if a child is asking for that and they're needing that, it's really important for us to get those for them.
Yeah. I think you just maybe answered my question. One of the questions in the chat was about, you know, if I pick somebody, but I can't fulfill the whole thing, can I just get them a portion of it? Would you prefer that they try and pair up with somebody when they take a child so that they can fulfill the whole thing? Or can you have people that say, well, I'm just going to do the coat for this kiddo, but I can't afford the rest?
Right. My goal each year is for each kid to have roughly 4 to 5 packages to open. Now, when I say that, I'm not meaning those to be $20 and $30 gifts each. You know, it may be a shirt in one box, a pair of pants in another, you know, socks and underwear in another, maybe the pair of shoes, whatever that combination is. If you aren't able to do that and you feel comfortable and want to pair up with somebody, that's great. If not, I always ask that you get as much as you can off the list of the things that are the more important emergency type items that they need, to work off of those first. And then we can always fill in with gifts. I do get people sometimes that just donate gifts for us to use. So I usually have some type of toy floating about that can usually fill in that place. But any help we can get, getting the names filled, a monetary donation, and don't think anything is too small. I mean, if all you have to offer is $5, that is great. I'm happy with $5 because that $5 can be put with maybe somebody's 20. And that ends up buying somebody a pair of shoes. So,
and you know, let me just say, if it's a struggle to do that digitally, are there ways we can have people drop off $5? Could they put it in an envelope and put it in the box at our front door?
Yes. That is perfectly fine. If doing that electronically doesn't work for you, and you want to just write a check, you can write a check, you can mail it into us, or as Sharon said, if you want to put it in an envelope and swing by our office, we have a large drop box out front. You can just put Giving Tree on the outside of it and drop it in there and it will get to me.
Outstanding. We did also have a question. Does the sign-up sheet have correct sizes?
Yes, it does.
I knew it did.
That is something that, again, sometimes you're going to see some sizes on there that you're like, there is no way this kid wears this size of clothes, especially like if it's a little kid, they may be 5, but they're asking for a size 10. And you're like, there's no way. I promise you, I have checked these sizes so many times with the coordinators, just to make sure, because. And again, it could be a child that's older, but yet they're wearing a much smaller size that it doesn't seem right. And it just can be, it can be their development so that they're just a smaller person. So they have been checked.
You talked about U.S. Bank being a helper before. Are there other ways that people that work for, maybe they work at a company that does some holiday outreach? How can we also leverage corporations?
So we do have a couple different places that are corporations that do connect with us, and they have been connecting with us for the last several years. Last year was really different. Last year, it was strictly monetary donations. I ordered things bulk offline, and the kids got gifts according to age groups and gender. Not really the best thing, but everybody was able to have something for Christmas. So that's one reason we have opened it up this year to putting it online, which allows the folks, they can go online, they can select the name, and then they can drop it off here. We do have these corporations that do participate with us. Sometimes they will take a group of names. They'll ask me for so many tags. I send those out to them. And then at their work, their corporation, different people take the names, buy for them, bring them back, and then we make arrangements for them to either drop them off here at the agency, or sometimes there might be a little caravan of a few of us that will go out and pick all the gifts up and bring them back. So do it that way. We also have a school, an all boys school that participates. And I think we're on like year six or so. It is a homeroom class. And their teacher is the one that is behind it every year. And he talks about it. I go in when it's time to pick up. I talk about it so that the boys all know what it's going for. They understand that what you get, whatever you give that child, is what they're going to get for Christmas. So it's really exciting to see the boys hop in there and, you know, buy the stuff. And a lot of them use their own money to buy the gifts for the kids. So it's pretty exciting. But yes, if there is a corporation, an agency, a choir group somewhere, they want to go together and pull their money together and buy for so many kids. If I know early on, I can pull like family groups together. So if you want a family of three kids, I can pull those out, so that I can give you the whole family. So what you're buying for is a family unit. That's a big thing that's really hard, is to be able to keep the gifts even within a family. Because sometimes you might have somebody that buys, six or seven gifts for one child, and then whoever's buying for the other one buys three. And you think, three, but when you're in that house, you all know when you were kids what it's like.
Oh, yeah.
And your brother or your sister gets more gifts than you. It's not fair, regardless of what it is. It's just not fair. So I try really hard to make sure things come out even. That's another thing that's really important.
We are one of many programs that help people that are in need over the holidays. So if you are part of the ARC network and you're not on our giving tree and you need some supports, you might want to reach out to one of the family navigators in my team and get links to the other programs that are available in our community. There's several giving programs. There's also a location where they have low cost, under market value gifts where you can purchase things for a low low amount of money so that you can get gifts under your tree or buy your menorah or whatever holiday you're celebrating. So if you need access to those resources, just contact us at the St. Louis Arc. One of our guests is asking about how you deliver, whether you dress up in costume or anything. And I know back in the day, it was really important to the parents to be able to put the gifts under the tree. Is that still the way you do it?
Yes. The coordinators mainly do the delivery to the home or to the program where they are. Because like I said, normally the kids that are at program are too young to kind of realize what's going on with the whole gift thing. But it is for the parents to be able to put those gifts under the tree for their kids for Christmas. We talk long and hard about, you know, taking them home, putting them away, saving them for Christmas for the kids, for this to be, you know, for them to see their joy on Christmas morning. And so we don't want to take that joy away from them by doing that.
I think you guys are really thoughtful about the way you organize the giving tree so that the focus is really on the families having a great moment, not us having a great moment. So although we have plenty of opportunity to really enjoy it, it's great to be able to participate. So if you're thinking about this, don't hesitate. You know, pick a smaller amount than maybe you think that you can handle just so you get your feet wet and give it a try. But I think you'll really enjoy participating. And if our tree isn't the right match for you, find another opportunity to connect with a family who really just needs a little bit of extra. And I think not only the gifts, but knowing that somebody cared enough to make a contribution also is a gift to these families. So hopefully you guys will be generous and think about that as well. Everybody out there, we're going to wrap up today, but don't forget about other people. It's the best thing about the holidays is being able to support somebody else. So if you can spare $5, drop it in a box somewhere or put it in an envelope and bring it to the Arc. If you can do more than that, check out our sign up list, but give to others. It's a great feeling, and happy holidays. They're almost here, everybody.